This video will cover the diagnostic criteria for brittle cornea syndrome, a subtype of Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. BCS is incredibly rare, with less than 1 in 1 million experiencing this syndrome. We are going to review the new 2017 diagnostic criteria for Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. The formal evaluation and genetic testing are required for a diagnosis, which include major and minor criteria. The major criteria for BCS include thin cornea, early onset keratoconus and keratoglobus, and blue sclery. Ketoconus is when your cornea bulges out in a cone shape, and keratoglobus is when it bulges out in a round shape. Individuals with either condition have worsening vision and may have severe pain or pressure in their eyes. Blue sclery is when the whites of the eyes have a blue tinge to them. This phenomenon is indicative of many types of EDS or other connective tissue disorders. Minor criteria for BC diagnosis include enucleation or corneal scarring, loss of corneal stromal depth, and hypercompliant tympanic membranes. Enucleation of the cornea is the loss of an eye. A hypercompliant tympanic membrane refers to pressure equalizing in the middle ear and other parts of the ear which reduce hearing. Further minor criteria includes high myopia, retinal detachment, and deafness. Myopia refers to nearsightedness, wherein people only have vision to see things clearly when they are far away. Retinal detachment can lead to blindness and is a medical emergency. Scoliosis, developmental hip dysplasia, hypotonia in infancy, mild. Soft and thin skin are more minor criteria. Hypotonia is decreased muscle tone, leading to weakness. The final minor criteria include hypermobility, pes planus, flat feet, hallux valgus, bunions, contractures of fingers, and arachnodactyly. Hypermobility is evaluated with the Beaton scale and indicates flexibility of joints. Bunions occur when your bone migrates outward of the normal foot. Contractures are muscle shortening, and finally arachnodactyly refers to long, slender fingers. BCS also has genetic criteria and has autosomal recessive inheritance, meaning a child needs both genes to get BCS. There is a 25% chance of passing on BCS if both parents are carriers of genes. There are two genes that can cause BCS. Gene ZNF for 69, which is also known as BCS, BCS1, or ZF for P69. This gene may function as a transcription factor or extranuclear regulator factor for the synthesis or organization of collagen fibers. The PRDM5 gene may regulate the expression of proteins involved in extracellular matrix development and maintenance, including collagens, COL4AM1 and COL11AM1, connective tissue components, and molecules regulating cell migration and adhesion. This is the end of the diagnostic criteria for brittle cornea syndrome. Please click the like and subscribe button if you'd like to learn more about Ehlers-Danlos syndrome and other rare conditions. You can also follow me on Instagram for more regular posts at chronic.care. Thanks for watching. Stay rare.